What's good, YouTube? Stormy B-Man, and I'm back with a pre-fight video. Before we get started, I'd like to say shout out to the LDBC, the Lion's Den Boxing Community, New Media, and Liberated Perspective, a third eye view of the world. For more content such as this, please like, comment, subscribe, and share. On Saturday, December 21st, we will get an opportunity to see a rematch for the WBC Super Welterweight Championship between Jermell Charlo and Tony Harrison, dubbed as Harrison Charlo 2. These two fighters fought back in 2018. December, and at the time Jermell Charlo was the champion. All right, Tony Harrison came into the fight with a record of 27-2. All right, he had suffered losses to the likes of Jared Herd, Willie Nelson, even won a split decision over Ishae Smith. Charlo was the heavy favorite in the fight, but due to the boxing of Tony Harrison and the reluctance to mix it up, Harrison fought a safety first fight, and Charlo found himself on the losing end of a decision. It was a shock. Charlo, who practically fell to pieces when the decision was announced, was totally crushed. He thought he had done enough with his offensive efforts to retain his title. But alas, a rematch would be in order. Now, this fight was originally scheduled for summer, but due to Harrison pulling out, claiming an ankle injury, the fight was nixed, and Charlo ended up taking on another fighter in the meantime. He took on Jorge Cota and stopped him very quickly inside of 2 rounds. Going into this fight, the initial press conference for the rematch found Tony Harrison disrespecting Jermell, calling him a cornball, saying all kinds of disrespectful things about how he dresses and where he comes from and things like that, boasting and bragging of himself being a Midwesterner from Detroit. This is all fine and dandy. Charlo, who has a record of 32-1 with 16 KOs, had found himself knocking opponents out as he began a knockout streak with Jose Angel Rodriguez. His power started coming into effect in his fights. That's what dictated the action of this fight when they fought the first time. Charlo, who does have emotion behind how he represents, is looking to come after this rematch, get his title back by putting on a display of aggression. Tactically, he's going to have to get on the inside. Harrison is a boxer with a punch. Not a boxer puncher, but a boxer with a punch. He has snapping power at the end of his shots. Charlo is going to have to get inside. This fight cannot be fought on the outside with Charlo. Jermell is going to have to get inside that jab, work combinations, hooking, body, head, working him up and down. And I believe he can do it. he's going to have to show that fortitude. Harrison, on the other hand, is under the belief that he's going to be able to box his way to victory again. I don't think that that's going to be the case. I don't think that Jermell is going to allow that. But if Jermell doesn't do the things that he has to do, this fight will find the similar result as the original match. The press conferences have been won hands down by Tony Harrison, with his gift of gab, being able to talk a good talk for the fight. But there's an old adage: empty cans rattle the loudest. He's gonna have to produce in the ring. It's fine to be a good talker, speak with bravado and all of that, but if your temperament isn't as aggressive as your words, it all is for naught. This is where I believe Jermell Charlo can make Harrison eat his words. Be focused. Unleash your fury of combinations to the body. Wear him down. Beat him down. Don't even worry about knockout shots to the head. When you do this, you'll bring those hands down naturally. And remember, in the later portion of the fight, after being battered, he won't be able to move as easily. He won't be able to lean back away from the shots as easily as early in the bout. You can do this, Jermell. I'm pulling for you. Harrison wants the easy route. I do believe he faked his injury earlier. He wanted more time. More time to enjoy the lap of luxury of being the champion, because his reign would be short. After his defeat to Hurd, he knew a defeat with Charlo would put him on the back burner for a bit, and he didn't like it. So he made him wait. But now it's time to make Harrison pay. I see it as this: will it be repeat or will it be revenge? Repeat would mean that Harrison prevails. He's able to box his way to victory, stay out of harm's way, add up points, and be in a safe place. This is his key to victory: staying behind his jab and boxing, keeping Charlo at the end of his shots. But if it's going to be revenge, Jermell is going to have to work. He's going to have to get inside. He's going to have to dog him. He's going to have to maul him. He's going to have to lay hands on him, punish him to the body. That's the way he can get his revenge. What do you think? This is Stormy B, man. That's all I have for you at this time. Until this fight rolls around, leave your comments in the comments section, and we'll speak again. Peace.